The fight against fentanyl is a top priority here in Florida and across the country, and one sheriff's office in the Big Bend is the first in the state to use a new tool to save lives.
You've probably heard of Narcan, the nasal spray that can save someone's life when they've overdosed on opioids. What you might not know is there are actually several other opioid reversal drugs on the market. This includes one that recently got FDA approval. It's called Opvee.
The Franklin County Sheriff's Office is now the first in the Sunshine State to start carrying it. Our Savannah Kelly has spent the last week looking into how this drug works, and she's in the studio right now. Savannah, what'd you find out?
Yeah, Julie, Jacob, at first I thought that this was going to be a straightforward story, just another tool in the toolbox for addressing the fentanyl crisis. But as you'll see, the more people we spoke with, the more we realized there are some mixed feelings about Opvee.
What is it?
This kind of call has become all too common. In Franklin County, Florida, more than 200 people overdosed on opioids in the last 4 years.
Pulse. I'm not feeling any. I'm not feeling one.
That's according to data from the sheriff's office.
I think I got a slow pulse or a weak pulse.
Thanks to two doses of Narcan, this call from 2022 had a positive outcome.
We need every tool we can that may save a life.
Franklin County Sheriff A.J. Smith says his deputies started carrying Narcan a few years ago. Pretty soon, they'll also be carrying this new tool to fight overdoses called Opvee.
Medicine and technology is changing every day, and we can't keep using the same thing that we used 5 years ago. So if there's something new, we want to try it. I mean, I don't think it hurts to try something new.
So what is Opvee? It's a nasal spray like Narcan. Both drugs can reverse an opioid overdose in minutes. The difference is Opvee stays in the body longer. Its half-life, or the time it takes for half of the drug to leave the body, is about 11 hours. Narcan's half-life is closer to 1 hour. Judy Dane is a representative with Indivior, Opvee's parent company. She says it's important for the drug to last a long time.
If the reversal agent wears off before the effects of the opioid wears off, then the person could actually end up overdosing again without consuming more opioids. Mm-hmm. So with Opvee lasting a long time, the hope is that it can reduce the occurrence of that.
But some doctors believe the long-acting nature of Opvee could be a double-edged sword.
You would predict that it would be more effective at reversing overdose, but at the same time, those properties that make it more effective at reversing overdose are going to make it more likely that it would cause unintended precipitated withdrawal symptoms.
That's Stephen Veal, an emergency physician based in Daytona Beach. Over the last 15 years, he's treated hundreds of patients for opioid overdoses. Veal says Opvee is more potent than Narcan, but he says that doesn't mean it's better.
Certainly that concern is there that are we going to induce unnecessary suffering, unnecessary precipitated withdrawal symptoms by using a stronger medication? And I think the reason people are so anxious is no one knows for sure.
The FDA approved Opvee in May of last year, deeming it safe and effective.
But there's not the clinical background. There's not the years of experience with it that there is with Narcan. And so I think people are really sort of pausing and wondering, you know, why make a change?
That's a question many harm reduction advocates are pondering.
You know, I was, like I said, excited about this at first, but upon closer look, I think we just need more Narcan in everybody's hands.
Susan Dodd lost her daughter Isabella to fentanyl in 2020. Now she tries to bring awareness to the issue, giving out Narcan and sharing her daughter's story.
I do this for my daughter. This is what she would have wanted. You know, I'm her voice now that she's gone.
Dodd thinks Opvee might do more harm than good. Tim Santamore with the Florida Harm Reduction Collective agrees.
It's moving in the opposite direction of compassionate care for folks.
Santamore worries Opvee could hinder patients with painful withdrawal symptoms for days. That, in turn, he says, could discourage people from getting help. I brought these concerns to Judy Dane with Indivior.
I'm not minimizing. Precipitated withdrawal is a painful process to go through, but it can be medically managed. If it's too late and the person dies, there's nothing you can do then.
I asked Dane what sets Opvee apart from Narcan, but she declined to make direct comparisons between the two. As for the Franklin County Sheriff's Office, Sheriff Smith told me he's not concerned at all about the potential for more intense withdrawal symptoms.
All I know is if it saves a life, then If it does take a little longer to withdraw, I think that's a small price to pay.
Sheriff Smith says for now, deputies will be carrying both Narcan and Opvee. He'll be encouraging deputies to use Opvee initially. If it proves more effective, Smith says they'll likely phase out Narcan and switch to Opvee completely.
Dane with Opvee's parent company says she's not aware of any other agencies in Florida that are using Opvee yet, so the Franklin County Sheriff's Office is likely the first. Sheriff Smith says the department paid out of pocket for this first shipment. Their Narcan supply is funded by a state grant, and his hope is that soon Opvee will also be covered.
All right, like so many things, there appear to be pros and cons with this. In terms of the timeline for Franklin County, when do they plan to start using it?
Yeah, Jacob, the sheriff told me that they are going to start training next week, likely, and will be equipping deputies shortly after that. So it could be very soon.
Yeah. All right.
Thank you, Savannah. Yeah, for looking into this, and we'll look to see where things stand in the weeks, months, and year ahead as far as use of this new drug. Thank you.
We'll be right back.